Hi everyone, welcome to this video. Let's paint a three-toed sloth. I'm going to start with black lines to outline the animal. And I'm going to start up here with the head. Notice the placement on the canvas, kind of in the center and up near the top. Notice the size of the shape that I'm making compared to the rest of the canvas here. I'm just going to draw in the part of the face where there isn't a lot of hair because it's kind of a distinct shape all on its own. I'm going to have an arm coming out over here. Notice the length that I'm, or the distance from here to here that I'm creating. It's about the same distance, maybe a little less if you were to put a line from the top of the head to the chin. And now we'll start with the body. This is kind of the belly area of the sloth. And then we have another arm. I'm going to actually angle it that way a little more. I am using a reference photo. And then we have a tree branch here. And then those are the toes. I'll turn that into three toes at some point. That is the part of the leg on this side of the body. And then this is the hind leg on this side here. That is my dog getting upset at the cat. This is kind of like the hip area here. And it's going to be grabbing around that part of the branch. I'm going to want to bring the branch in front of that hind leg. And then so this leg is coming out from behind here, and you may see a little bit right there. I do feel this is a little maybe crowded on the right side, but we'll see how it turns out. If you want, you can place the, kind of shift everything over. And then we have the back part of the sloth there. Notice the size of the body compared to the size of the head. It's about maybe two or three times, or two and a half times as big. And create a nice sweeping curve there. So sloths are actually the slowest mammal on Earth, and they live mostly in the trees. One reason I did place the head where I did at the beginning was because I knew this one arm was actually going to be taking up a large portion of the canvas with it outstretched the way it is. I will add the toes in a moment, just creating the basic shape there, kind of to show the hand. Or the palm area, if they do have palms, I'm not really sure. And then we've got three toes here, which we will add more detail to later. Basically, even though I'm making this all pretty much black, when I go back in with my color, I can just create three lines to show the toes. Go ahead and place some eyes. Kind of slanting them up, they're kind of an oval shape, but of course, every sloth is a unique individual and will have unique characteristics. And notice the placement of the nose is pretty close to the mouth there. I think I'm gonna go in, well, I'm gonna darken this over here. I am painting, sitting to the side with my computer to record this very close to the canvas, so it's a bit challenging. But who doesn't love a good challenge? Hopefully you're set up in a nice comfortable position. And so for composition sake, I'm gonna create another tree branch over here, going behind the one arm. You can make it a thicker branch if you want, or trunk of the tree, so it could just completely go off the edge there. It's up to you. You don't even need to create another tree if you don't want. This is your creation. going to create some leaf shapes. Creating a nice canopy of leaves. And notice how this leaf is going behind the branch, so you're going to want to make sure there's a continuous line or an imaginary line that would be behind the branch there. You can make the leaves in different shapes or different angles as well. Maybe generally the same shape since they're from the same tree. You're welcome to, again, create your background however you'd like. I'm just going to add another branch right here so we can kind of carry the shapes around. So I will add some more leaves in this area. I work with heavy-bodied acrylic paint, so sometimes I don't put enough water on it to really get the consistency I want, making it more of a dry brush technique, which is useful sometimes, but right now I want to be able to lay down a thicker, more prominent black line. I'm just trying to add a little more water as I mix it on my palette. Going to add a leaf over here. I wanted to break up that space a little bit. And another leaf here to kind of repeat the shape. And then I am going to leave that area open And I think that's all for the black line for the first layer. So the brush I was using is kind of a thin brush. I'm not sure if they call this a spotter. It's a little bit flat on the top as well. I don't see it written on the brush. But now I'm going to switch to a different brush to start on the background. This is a filbert brush, one of my favorites to use. And you can see the size I'm using so that I can cover more area. And we're gonna go ahead and feel free to use whatever colors you enjoy. So sloths not only move slow, but all of their body functions are also slow. So it takes them about 2 weeks to digest a meal. And they are found in Central and South America. And my black paint may not be dry yet, so I'm going to do my best to not touch the parts that are wet. You are welcome to allow yours to dry before you head on to this next step. Oh, see, right there, we got some black in there, not a big deal. We'll just kind of blend it in a little. When I'm painting, if I want to make a color darker, I have never actually added black to it. I always try to find some other color, such as ultramarine blue, or burnt sienna, or both of those. When you actually mix both of those together in equal parts, it does create a nice black. My canvas is moving a little. Not sure if you can see that, which just means it's not as tight as it could be. Normally you want the canvas to be taut. There is a way to actually correct that by lightly wetting the back of the canvas. I would usually use my fingers to put the water on. And then as it dries, the canvas becomes tighter. And I may have to switch to a smaller brush shortly to get into these tighter spots. But this is good to, oop, got some more black in there. This is good to really lay the color down quickly. And let's see. So I want to give a shout out to Adria. She is a lover of all animals, and especially sloths. this color I'm using is actually, I'm not mixing with any other color. It is straight out of the jar. And I will have the colors listed in the description. I believe this is some type of a teal. And it looks like it is time to switch to a smaller brush. I'm actually getting some new brushes in soon, so I'm very excited about that. Okay. We'll try this one. The bristles are a little stiff because I didn't clean them thoroughly, or as thoroughly as I could have, which sometimes happen when I'm painting on scene and don't have access to running water. So I just try to clean them as best I can with the water I have. And notice how much easier it is with this size to really get into the smaller areas. So this is the size that I'm using. Also a filbert. So one thing with sloths, when they are on the ground, which is not their normal place of living, they can be vulnerable to other animals. And so their claws can actually be used for protection. As you're creating this, I hope you are just enjoying the process and not judging things that you may think are mistakes. And also not comparing it to mine, because you are a unique artist and I am a unique artist. So it's going to always look different, even if we're painting the same subject. And that is part of the beauty of art making. And oftentimes something we think is a mistake is actually just an opportunity to learn. It's about exploring. And this could be a leaf here if you want it to be. I'll leave it right now as a leaf. I may go back in if I decide I want the teal color there instead, compositionally. I may do that. We'll see once we start on the leaf color. I think we've got the background color laid down. And for the leaf, the leaves, I'm using a yellow. I believe it's cadmium yellow medium. And then blue manganese. Not sure if that's how you pronounce it. Hue. There's still a little bit of teal on my paintbrush, but can't really tell. Just blending it right into the color. You can make the leaves various shades of green as well to give it some variety. I'm just going to go in and lay the basic color down first, and we can add more detail perhaps on another layer. And feel free to paint at your own pace. I am going to try to paint a little quicker just for purposes of keeping this video shorter. And we have a lot of leaves to color. I actually think I do like the fact that that's a lot of green there, to really suggest that there's a larger canopy up here. There's always something going on when you have animals. And it being winter outside with lots of snow, my dog does not get as much exercise as she would like. I really enjoy the color combination here. Color is such an important part of art and in life in general. It does a variety of things when you look at it. It can make you feel calm. Depending on the color, can make you feel energized. Okay, so now I'm gonna start on the branches using a little bit of yellow. And again, I did not clean my brush off, which is fine. It's just carrying a little bit of that green color into it. And I'm mixing burnt sienna with yellow and white. you can add or change the color a little bit to give it some variety if you want. I may do that if we have time for another layer. But you can make it darker in some areas, lighter in others. And if you notice, I just painted right over that line because this branch was an afterthought and we don't actually need that black line there unless you want it to show that the branch is kind of coming out on the other side of the trunk there. And we're getting a little thin down there maybe for this paintbrush, but you can try it. Okay, looks like we are finished with the branches for the first layer. I'm going to grab my larger filbert that I used for the teal color here. And we're going to place the first layer of the fur down. Going to use some burnt sienna and ultramarine blue, a little bit of yellow, and there's probably a little white in there from being on my brush and on my palette. So I am making the first layer a little darker, even though the fur is lighter. So we'll go back in after and add lighter aspects of it. And I'm gonna actually try to make my brush marks the way the fur does go on the animal. So I'm noticing that it sweeps down. But that's really more important, I would say, for the subsequent top layers that we put on. And it's not necessarily a uniform color as well. I am noticing there's a lot more shading around the head here, or underneath the head, and on the body to show shadow. I'm making this a little bit lighter just by adding some white. Again, I'm using a larger brush because I want to just place down a lot of color in a shorter amount of time. just going to go ahead and add some lighter layers there while I have a slightly lighter color on my brush. Just to sort of place the lighter areas where I may want to go in later. And that would have probably been good to use a small brush for, but that's okay. But I will switch to a small brush now, smaller brush. I'm using this filbert that I used for the green leaves. Making a lighter color for this part of the face. I'm actually going to change the shape a little bit and bring that darker color down a little bit more. They do have a darker color around their eyes. Which I had too much white on my brush to be able to create there. So I've taken some of it off. Now I'm using mainly burnt sienna and ultramarine blue. And let's see, it also has a darker area for around the nose. I actually want that to be a little darker. So not that dark in some of those areas. One thing with acrylic paint is that it does dry darker than what you place it down wet. So that is something to keep in mind. Okay, I think we need to switch to a smaller brush to get in there around the mouth. So I'm going to switch to this size here. And I made the chin a little bit deeper than I wanted to, but that's okay because, again, they're all individual looking animals, and we can go in and modify that later if we'd like. I'm gonna go in and place some color for the toes. I guess they would be considered their claws. So kind of an off-white. I'm using a smaller brush. This is the one I used at the beginning to create my black lines. And then be sure to notice how the tops of the claws are extended a little bit beyond where the edge of the tree branch is, to show that it's wrapping around. And I think we've got our first layer done. And what I normally do with my style is I tend to add a few layers, and so I will go back over the black line again in most places. And then we'll go back in with some more color. So this is actually a different brush from what I initially used for the black. It's a little bit smaller, also a little bit frayed from use. And try to create the consistency of the paint that you want, depending on what you're using or maybe you're drawing. And I think I will start on the right here so that I don't end up smearing some wet paint if I need to lay my hand on the canvas to study it. Of course, some of the color may still be wet. But I generally am placing my heel of my hand to study it a little bit. Maybe we can suggest the toes right there, as that's wrapping around the tree branch from the other side. This is the foot part of this back leg here. And what we can do is also go in and just add some more shapes there to show where the hair might be kind of extending. Though usually it just kind of comes down, looks like maybe to like a point for like the elbow, and then we'll go back in with some detail after and carry that hair down there. when I'm painting and not making a video. I'm usually listening to some music. So feel free to put on some of your favorite tunes. So since the head is actually more forward than this arm here, we're going to bring this line here to show that the arm is more in the background there. And also I'm going to continue that line actually because it's showing that that whole arm is on the other side of the belly. Not really too much to say as I go in with these lines, except that art making can be a nice meditative process, good for stress relief. And just a good way to have fun and explore and spend some time. I'm not sure if you can tell by the sound of my voice that I do kind of go into a slightly meditative state, putting my logical mind on the back burner, so to speak. I'm just going to go ahead and make these eyes completely black, and then we can add the details later. got a little bit of dried paint there. It was kind of clumping up. So I was just trying to get it off the canvas. And again, you can notice with that line, I'm carrying in front of the arm line to show where it is in space. To show that the arm is slightly behind the head. Same with this here, it shows that this part of the arm is a little bit on a slightly different plane than the rest of the arm. You can actually do the same thing on trees if you wanted to add a little line there. It's up to you. I may actually go back in and paint over that when we add more color. Gonna make those toes a little more prominent since it is a three-toed sloth. So I'll bring some emphasis to that. Okay, got their second layer of black line on. And what do I want to do next? How about try trying to find the size brush that I want to use to go into the leaves. I am looking forward to getting my new paintbrushes. Okay, let's see. This one may work. It's a little bit frayed. Not sure what kind of paintbrush it is, whether it's a filbert or was a filbert. Looks like it may have been a round. Alright, so I'm just going to go in with some highlights of green. I'm actually using a different green mixed in with the yellow to go in and just kind of give it some shading, you know, like right here where this leaf is behind that leaf. So be a little bit in shadow, and just because leaves tend to have a lot of different angles going on sometimes, or the way the light is shining through the leaves gives them a little bit of dimension. And one thing I'm also doing as I do this is I'm shaping the black line a little more, or completely taking it away, but we'll just go back in and later and sharpen that black line again. I'm really grateful that I do have these new paint brushes and paints coming. I'm grateful that I have access to art supplies and that I can afford them, because unfortunately not everyone is able to access the supplies that allow them to do this. Okay, now that we've got the darker green laid out, I'm gonna lighten it up a bit using that same green, which will be listed in the description, a yellow, and a little more white, and then just keep adding different colors to it until you get the color you think you want. Oh, and that's not really the color I want. So I'm going to add some more green to that. I think I'm going to actually go back to my original green color, which I made using the blue manganese hue, which is a nice bright blue, and just continue to mix that into what I just created. Adding a little more yellow and some white. Okay, that's not really popping out there yet. And also keep in mind that that is going to darken as it dries, so it'll probably not be very noticeable at all compared to the other colors that I've placed on it. So I'm continuing to add a little more white and yellow. And that gives it a nice little bit of contrast and variety. Not as bright a green as I had originally anticipated, but it is what it is, and I think it works pretty good. We're just exploring color here and the interplay among other colors. You may want to keep it that very vibrant green that we started out with at the beginning. Okay. That's all for the leaves for now. I'm going to go back into the tree bark a little bit. Maybe with a lighter brown. Still have a little bit of that green on my brush, which is okay. Depends on what you want to do. So I'm mixing burnt sienna, with yellow and white. Just to give it a little bit of shape. Maybe suggest the bark. Barks on trees look different depending on the kind of tree it is. Some are smoother, which is what I am treating this tree as. I'm not sure what kind of tree it is. So sloths tend to live to be about 12 years old. Perhaps this is a eucalyptus tree. I'm not sure what kind of trees they have in Central and South America. Maybe the eucalyptus is only found in Australia. And notice I'm placing the lighter color like on the top there. There's a lot of white that just kind of appeared, which is okay. But I'm going to blend it in a little bit more. So placing it on the top kind of shows that there is a imaginary light source, well, the sun, coming from above here and shining down. I'm going to leave that there until I can get a smaller brush into this area. And now we're going to go in and add another layer to the fur. Using this size filbert. Not sure what number it is because my paintbrush is pretty old and has worn off the handle. Okay, so for this color that we're putting on the second layer of fur, I am mixing white with ultramarine blue and burnt sienna. There's a little bit of green in there as well. I actually may end up adding kind of a green tint. I think I'm gonna, well, let's see what this does. Might add like a green tint to the fur at some point because their fur actually often has a very unique ecosystem on it. And it grows algae. So this is slightly dry brush. To kind of give it more texture. You can see there, as opposed to, and I'm just placing my paintbrush on it using a certain pressure. Whether, depending on how much paint's on my brush, and whether I want it to be darker or lighter. And notice the directions that I'm making these marks, using it in the direction that the fur goes. So you can kind of see the shape of the limb there. Fur looks a little bit messier over here. And again, we're going to go back down and show the elbow area where we placed that new black line. Actually, that is giving me an idea to come back in over here. And create more of a tip, showing the fur coming to a point there as well. Trying to allow some of the darker color that I placed on there to show through. Just mixing some more color. sometimes you can try to mix all the color that you're going to need for the area that you're painting, but I tend to just keep remixing as I go. And it can be challenging to create the exact color that you made before, but you don't necessarily need to have the exact color either. I'm actually making a little bit of a darker color to place on this part of the leg to show that it's receding into the back a little bit. And also maybe right there as well. And then some more shading underneath the head here for some shadow. Again, using burnt umber and ultramarine blue. And maybe we have a darker color down here to show the shape a little bit more, where there's less light reaching the bottom area there. You can even add some texture if you want, meaning thicker strokes of paint like I did there. Could maybe go back in with a smaller brush to show some finer hair. Make this a little darker here. A little bit of dry brushing. Adding some white to that, I'm just going to go in and highlight some of the patterning there. adding some highlights kind of in the center of the body here to show the shape and where the light may be hitting it. And then again, highlighting the top of this leg here. Notice I'm kind of making some lines going in a slightly different direction to show the layering. A little more orange than I want it to be. Okay, I think that's all with his paintbrush for now. Maybe we will continue to add a little bit of detail. So I'm switching. Size brush. This is just tape that I've used to repair this brush. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do is just add some detail to the fur with this smaller brush. Just add it in certain areas, not a lot, but just something to give it a little more variety. May even want to use a really smaller brush than what I'm using to create some finer hairs. Maybe I will switch to a slightly smaller brush. So I'm moving to this brush here, which is the one I used for our second layer of black line. And again, keep in mind that, so I'm gonna actually maybe mix a little bit of green in here too, we'll see what happens. Keep in mind that, and the green is to show the algae that's kind of on their fur, because they often have kind of a green tint. But keep in mind again that this color that you place down, if you're using acrylic, will darken. So the contrast, so it will darken when it dries, so the contrast won't be as great as what you see when you first place it down. do have a tendency to not mix enough color initially. So I have to keep remixing on my palette. And if you'd like to see, this is what my palette looks like currently. I'm just working on a piece of plywood that has plastic tape to it and a canvas strap on the back so I can hold it easily in my hand. And let's see, I'm going to go in and paint the little toes that are kind of peeking in here. Looks like we're only going to see two of them, even though it is a three-toed sloth. And then I'm going to go back in up here, highlight those. And we might as well go in over here and emphasize those as well. Now to finish some more detail in the hair. Making it a little bit darker to add some dark details in the hair in certain areas. So we didn't want to use as light of a color that I created before. For this dark area there, we want it to kind of these two colors to be somewhat close. And also some details in the shadows here. One thing about sloths is they do have very distinctive, looks kind of, never pet a sloth, I don't think you really are supposed to if you're ever near one, because the ecosystem on their fur is very fragile, but their fur, their hair looks kind of wiry to me. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little bit of detail around the eyes, going in with the dark color. Again, using, it's not as dark as I'd like it, using burnt sienna, ultramarine blue, and some of the whites. They do tend to have a distinctive darker patterning around their eyes and also their noses. Go in and separate those little nostrils. maybe this darker color right there is kind of showing a little bit of the chin detail. And again, I use my, I can use my color to try to shape the black lines the way I want to make them. And it looks like they actually have quite a bit of the darker patterning around the eyes actually also extends, at least in this photo I'm working from, extends further on the side of the face. I'm not sure if that's a typical pattern for most sloths, but it's kind of carries that color further down. Okay, I like how that looks. I like the shape of the mouth. I'm just gonna go in maybe with a little bit of black at some point. But right now I'm gonna add the kind of an off-white to the eyes to show where the light would be shining. Oh, I'm gonna go in and with some black after and kind of change that a little. Now sometimes I would add, I never really know what I'm gonna do necessarily as I'm creating the background for these paintings. Sometimes I'll add spirals or dots or other little shapes. I kind of enjoy just the flat teal that I put there, especially since the rest of it is kind of has a lot going on with the leaves, so I don't think I need to really add anything to the teal part of the background. I am going to go back into the bark a little bit though, and with my smaller brush, and just add some highlights and maybe some more details. To show that maybe it's got some little dots. And one thing that's doing is it's actually repeating the shape of the eyes, the dots that I put in the eyes there. And it's just giving it a little bit more variety. And also kind of repeating some of the shapes of the hair. making it a little bit lighter, because you can actually see those light marks that were there have kind of faded. Well, not faded, but they've dried to the darker version and kind of blended right in. Okay, I think that's all for the branches there. I think I'll go back in with a little bit of black on certain parts. Where I covered up that part of the leaf. And just do a little bit of refining in certain areas. I'm going to make this look a little bit more like fur or hair. Go back in and reshape that white mark that we made earlier. And also that part of the mouth there. I'm going to round that little area out. I am noticing that I would like the face to kind of pop out a little bit more, so I'm going to add some lighter highlights. I'm not sure if you can hear my dog kind of yawning in the background, wanting some attention. So I'm using white, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of ultramarine blue, and burnt sienna. Actually going to add quite a bit more white to that because I know that once that dries it will not be noticeable, which is what happened with the previous layer that I thought was really light, but it just blended right in. I'm adding a little blue to that as well, because it had kind of a, I don't know, more of a peachy color that I didn't want. Few more marks to just highlight the belly here. Maybe he's got a little smile line there, he or she. Okay. Now I think I have actually decided. We'll see what happens. But I do want to add a little bit to the background and the teal part, so I'm just creating kind of an off-white using the small brush. And you can go ahead and do whatever you'd like. It's your creation. But I'm gonna add maybe some small dots here and there. I don't really know what they are. Just marks on canvas right now. Not really sure what I'm trying to depict. If anything, really. Anything realistic. Just think it gives it a little something. But it all depends on what you're going for. Maybe it's little bits of sunlight hitting something somewhere in the distance. Notice I'm not covering every area, just kind of concentrating them in certain areas around the canvas. Sorry about that. And again, I'm going to go in with a little bit more of a lighter color, hopefully, to highlight the face again, because it seems to keep darkening more than I would like. That'll also be darker once it dries. And maybe just a few highlights on the three toes here. And also the three toes on this side. It's a little challenging for me to reach over here and create some detail. Could probably turn that into three toes as well. So why don't we try to do that since it is a three-toed sloth. Just a little more white for the eyes there. And a little bit of black. For the nostrils and the mouth. I actually want to go back in there and reshape the mouth a little bit with some color. And I'm just gonna round out. It's not round, but I just wanted to refine that line a little bit. And maybe suggest some more hair there. I'm just kind of looking around the painting to see if there's anything I want to refine a little bit, and I think we can probably call this one finished. There, now it's finished. Okay, well, I had fun. I hope you did too. If you'd like to share your creation with me, I would love to see it. And thank you so much for joining me.